This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Hello and welcome to The Unstoppable Indians. Every week we take a journey into the life of an outstanding Indian, a person whose talent, acumen or moral example is transforming India. The best, the finest from every field join me, Manvi Dhillon, on this show to share their life story, their journey to success, some of the knocks along the way, what made them get up and keep going, what makes them an unstoppable Indian. My guest today is 25 years old and he's achieved what no Indian ever has, an individual gold at the Olympic Games. It's indeed a great pleasure, Abhinav, to have you on the Unstoppable Indians with me today. Thanks very much for making the time.
Thank you.
You know, has it really sunk in, because I'm sitting here at your home in Chandigarh and you look, well, it seems like another day in the life of Abhinav Bindra, but it's not even been 2 weeks since you created history in this country. Has it sunk in?
Yes, I think so. I mean, I'm not the kind of person who likes to make a big fuss of things. I mean, I'm extremely happy to have achieved my goal. And for me, life goes on, time to move on. And one thing that in sport, yesterday never counts. You're as good as what you're on the day. So I'm just looking forward to the future now.
Yesterday never counts. Well, that yesterday, that remarkable yesterday, was only 2 weeks ago. So for us, I think it's a moment of great celebration. Tell me, what was that moment like when you actually realized that you'd won the gold?
I was laughing a lot. I was just laughing at the moment and laughing at myself that, hey, I finally did it. And extremely happy, extremely proud, and living a dream. I mean, it's like a dream come true. It's like a fairy tale almost.
Does that mean that now you feel a sense of void?
Absolutely. I mean, I felt the same even after the last Olympic Games. Even if I didn't succeed, I didn't win a medal, but an Olympic athlete works for an Olympic Games for 4 years, day in and day out, and then the games get over, and then for a little while you have nothing to look forward to before you start again.
So tell me, how do you start again? Because, you know, here it is, you just said it in your own words, it's the dream that's come true. How does the process of setting another goal, of motivating yourself all over again, how does that process begin again?
I think I need some time. I think that's the most important thing. I need some time to just reflect back and time to myself, and just to find the energy again. I think that's the most important thing. I mean, competing at an Olympic Games is a very draining experience. It's the ultimate pressure an athlete would face, and it's draining, it's tiring, and just need some time to recharge my batteries and then attempt to set new goals.
Well, you've drawn me towards an area which I'm very tempted to ask you about. What is that training period like? I mean, what was your regimen like? What was your daily routine like?
For the last 11 years, I've been just training and training and training. I mean, there have been very, very few days that I've taken off. Probably on my travel days are off days. I've trained 6 to 7 hours every day, day in and day out. And yes, I'm so used to training now, so it's just boring at the moment.
So are you training post the Olympic gold as well?
Not as yet, but I have to find the energy to do it. It's been tiring.
And 2006, post the gold at the World Championships, you were also battling a troublesome back. How did you rebound from that?
It took a lot of courage, it took determination, a lot of hard work, a lot of training. But the Olympics were always my goal. I mean, the World Championships was probably a bigger competition in my sport than the Olympics. But the Olympics, the aura attached to the Olympics is just something else. And it had always been my dream and my goal to win it. And so just that kept me going.
And the 2000 Olympics, the 2004 Olympics, did each of those experiences actually build up to this moment in 2008?
Absolutely. I think 2000 was my first Olympics. I was only 16, I think, that time. I was just happy to be there. 2004, I really believed that I could win. I came very close. And 2008, I went with a different attitude. I mean, I was detached from the winning bit. My only goal was to give it my best and perform to the best of what I have. And I was detached from the outcome.
I'm going to go back to the very beginning, to, you know, maybe a 8-10-year-old boy. How did you know that you wanted to shoot?
I was growing up, I was always fascinated by guns, living on a farm in Dehradun, where my father had some guns, and on a Sunday or something he used to clean his guns or something, so it was always a fascination. But it was only when we moved to Chandigarh I took shooting up as a sport. I had no idea of rifle shooting or pistol of Olympic shooting sports, and my only I always imagined shooting to be archery, and that was what I always dreamt to do. Actually, I've never done it, so maybe I can fulfill that dream of at least going for some archery now.
And so how old were you when you signed up here in Chandigarh to actually start training to be a professional shooter?
I was 13. I was introduced to a coach here. A family friend introduced to me to my first coach, Lieutenant Colonel Dhillon. And yes, I went to his house and just got started. And
you knew that you wanted to do this for the rest of your life?
It was very addictive to train. I mean, I had the passion to excel, and that was the driving force. At that moment I didn't know that I would one day be Olympic champion. I mean, it was just step by step. I just took it step by step and kept slowly moving up the ladder.
Your parents, they've been right there, rooting for you, supporting you in whatever way that you needed. Describe that relationship that you have with your parents when it comes to shooting for us.
I mean, they're very, very supportive. Over the years, they've learned a lot about sport and how it works, and they perfectly understand that in sport there is no guarantee, and yet they took the risk to still back me, which is quite, I don't understand why they did it, but they did it, and they've been extremely supportive right from the beginning.
At a cost, which they have borne themselves, and today at the point that you are, do you wonder why there weren't other sponsors, corporations that could have invested in your career, or is that just water under the bridge?
It's ended well. I'm just happy. But that's the unfortunate part of Indian sport. We pay absolutely no attention to Olympic sports, and yet we expect a lot out of our athletes, which is just not realistic. And unfortunate that we don't have any backing for Olympic sports. I think it's time to make a start, and I think it should be done.
Are you optimistic that your win could be that starting point?
I mean, I have hope. I mean, every life revolves around hope. I don't know what will happen, but I have hope.
You were in Beijing. I mean, that is China is a country that has almost perfected the art of winning medals at the Olympic Games. When you look around at the Chinese Olympic sportsman, the athlete, what thought crosses your mind?
I mean, the Chinese Olympic, they have a very strong system in place. I don't say that system will work in India, but there's so much pride attached to the Olympics. There's so much pride attached to winning gold medals, and that is that's very commendable. And there's a lot at stake. There's a lot of national pride at stake, and everybody who runs sport in China feels it as is very responsible, and works with a lot of responsibility and a lot of passion that they win a lot of medals, and that's something we can draw a lot of inspiration from.
When you look at your peers, your colleagues in the Indian Olympic squad, do you think that, I mean, it's unfair of me to ask you to speak on their behalf, but, you know, is their hope barometer, their hope level fairly high, despite the obvious setbacks that they're coming in with into the games?
I have a lot of admiration for the Indian athlete. The Indian athlete goes through a lot of stuff, a lot of obstacles, yet he or she never gives up, and that's just remarkable. I have full, I really believe in the Indian athlete and believe that the Indian athlete is capable of winning a lot of medals, except the Indian athlete I don't believe is backed enough and supported enough, and that's something which every Indian athlete deserves, and deserves the opportunity to go out there and perform.